Señor presidente,
Mr. Chairman, Director General, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the delegation of the Republic of Cuba would like to extend a warm welcome to you, sir, as the chair of the 17th CSP. We would like to express our trust in your leadership and are certain that you will lead us to a successful session. I would also like to take this opportunity to welcome the new vice chairs of the CSP and to the chair of the Committee of the Whole and to the other officials of this conference that is just starting. I would also like to welcome the new directors of the Technical Secretariat who are here with us today as well. The delegation of Cuba fully supports the statement made by the distinguished representative of the Islamic Republic of Iran on behalf of the Non-Aligned Movement and China that are states party to the Chemical Weapons Convention. We would also like to focus on a variety of issues that we believe are of utmost importance. Mr. Chairman, weapons of mass destruction constitute the most significant threat to international peace and security. Cuba would like to restate its position in favor of complete and comprehensive disarmament under strict and effective international control that comprises the prohibition and the elimination of all weapons of mass destruction. The destruction of all categories of chemical weapons remains one of the fundamental objectives of the Convention. It should be complied with as quickly as possible, pursuant to the relevant decisions adopted at the 16th session of the Conference of States Parties and by the Executive Council at its 67th session. Failure to do so would undermine the credibility and integrity of the Convention. Mr. Chairman, the delegation of Cuba would like to express its gratitude to the Technical Secretariat for its report on the status of Article 11 implementation. We thank it as well for the efforts it's undertaking within the Division of International Cooperation and Assistance. The OPCW plays an important role when it comes to promoting the process of economic and technological development in states parties, and in particular in the least developed states. Unfortunately, the complete, effective, and non-discriminatory implementation of Article 11 of the Convention remains in abeyance. The non-discriminatory implementation of the Convention means that there can be no restrictions between states parties other than those established in the Convention itself. All states parties have the legitimate right to play an active role in the broadest possible exchange of chemicals, equipment, and information for purposes not prohibited by the Convention. And at the same time, all states parties have an obligation to facilitate this exchange. It is unthinkable and unacceptable that some states take measures, unilateral measures, that limit, restrict, or even prohibit, in many cases, the free exchange between states parties of chemistry. The blockade imposed by the government of the United States for more than 50 years now stands as a flagrant violation of this multilateral treaty, and in particular, Article 11 thereof. Therefore, we must eliminate these discriminatory restrictions, including the blockade against Cuba, for they fly in the face of the letter and spirit of the Chemical Weapons Convention. Cuba believes that we must give priority to adopting as quickly as possible an action plan for the full, effective, non-discriminatory implementation of Article 11. Just as we have done with other articles of the Convention. In fact, our country shall be coming forward with a concrete proposal very shortly so that the other states' parties parties can take it into consideration. Mr. Chairman, my delegation would like to thank the efforts of the Secretariat and other states' parties by organizing regional meetings and annual meetings of the national authorities. At the same time, we would like to subscribe to the priorities agreed by the most recent GRULAC meeting that was held in Costa Rica. Mr. Chairman, the third review conference of the Chemical Weapons Convention will give us all a unique opportunity to restate the principles and objectives of the convention and to adopt agreements that will have major implications for the future of the convention, being mindful, as ever, of its four fundamental pillars: destruction, verification, assistance, and international cooperation. Cuba renews its pledge to continue working closely with all states' parties in a transparent, inclusive, and constructive manner in order to have a positive outcome at the review conference, something that will further strengthen the convention. A multilateral approach for disarmament is the only effective and sustainable way to maintain international peace and security. We will once again renew our support to you so that at this session of the Conference of States Parties we can have a successful conclusion. We request that this document be circulated as an official document of the 17th Conference of the States Parties to the Convention on Chemical Weapons. Thank you very much.